Hello everyone, this is Mr. Random Generator. In this video, I will be starting a new series called Tech Versus. This series will be all about comparing similar technologies, file types, and much more. Main objective of this series is not about to find which one is necessarily better, but rather which one is used on which settings. So, in this video, we will be starting off by comparing YAML versus JSON. Let's look at JSON first. What JSON stands for is JavaScript Object Notation. According to JSON organization, JSON file structure is built on two structures. First, a collection of name-value pairs. Those name-value pairs correspond to various terminologies in different languages. For example, they could be called as an object, dictionary, hash map, and so on. Second is the array structure. Now, let's look at this JSON file. As you can see, we have few value key pairs. After that, we have an array which consists of other key value pairs. JSON is actually very flexible when it comes to structuring your file, and this is the reason why it is used extensively for various purposes. Now we can move forward to YAML file. So it stands for YAML and JSON Markup Language. I know, developers love recursive acronyms. So what is the purpose of YAML? YAML is a data representation language. However, it is designed in a way that it is easier to read by humans. So unlike JSON, it uses indentation as a nesting separator, so just like in Python. So let's examine a sample YAML file. You can immediately notice that it does have a cleaner and much more minimal look. So this feature of YAML makes it perfect for creating configuration files. At the top, we have three dashes which symbolizes and marks the start of the document. Just like JSON, it does have key value pairs and arrays. As you can see, key value pairs are separated by colon and array elements start with dash. You can also see that in YAML, we have comment feature, which can be done by using the hash sign. On a side note, it is beneficial to say that YAML can be considered as a superset of JSON in some ways. For instance, JSON syntax like that is still valid in YAML files. As now we briefly looked up into two formats, now we can compare them. As for the usage, JSON is mainly used for serialization and serving data. YAML is mainly used for configuration. As for the performance, JSON is generally has better parsing performance, but it obviously is dependent on the parser. If we move on and look at readability, YAML is clearly much more human readable when compared against JSON, and the difference is especially much more noticeable when working with large files. Commenting support is also an important difference. Unlike YAML, JSON doesn't support commenting. Parser availability is another key point. So JSON parsers tend to be more common and be easily implemented in a lot of circumstances and in a lot of programming languages this is actually not the generally not the case for YAML. And finally, YAML has vast amount of additional features like anchors and aliases and so on. So that basically summarizes this video. Hope you like it. If that is the case, make sure to hit the like button and consider subscribing. If you have any recommendations for the next comparison, I would like to hear it in the comments below. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Take care.